right, here we are. We are back in action. Hawk, preferring to go that Bastion again. He's been really digging this, and it's been working.
Looks like we got a shout out here in the chat for Team Jade.
And SJ Ripper specifically. Yeah. Doctors of Gaming.
Yes.
Awesome blog. Definitely check it out, even if you are or are not a doctor.
Well, it means two things. If you really like gaming and you think you're good enough to call yourself a doctor of gaming, I think you could qualify.
I mean, I think I deserve a degree at this point. I mean, I've probably put in the time for it. All right, so we've got a little Bastion coming out of Team Jade here.
Bastion offensive, too, which is I see more and more often now.
Well, Hawk made this work again really well on Dorado. Very similar style, escort the payload the whole way. And look at him, just totally chasing him down. But Freeze-Jaws him, frees his friend.
Yeah.
And he goes down with trying, grabbing those hooks.
And look, and they baited him off the payload to fight. They got off of Big Earls.
Yep, but, you know.
Oh, there's Ari with the hook. And a hook back.
Out of the... Didn't have the shots there. He ran out. Trying to pick up Sloth. Hook is down. Probably really wished it wasn't. Trine goes down, and Team J just keeps it moving.
All right.
Link trying to hope that he magically gets a res. No, look at that. Hmm. Sneaky. Sneaky Mercy.
Look at
getting
that.
Right by that Roadhog and rejoining his team where it's
safe.
He's probably wishing he had his res too, but
yeah,
it's hard to build up.
Especially this early in the game too, so.
Yep. Team Sapphire taking the high point. Which is very useful.
Because it can come right down on him. Look at that save. Is that, who's 09 up there? Is that Will?
Who?
He's 09. Ignite.
Oh, that is Will, yes.
So I was going to say that Zarya placement was good, and he gets run down. But it was good when he was up on top of the Big Earls there. It was nice placement. He was playing the cover off the building very well.
Oh, yeah. These teams are just totally shredding. You got this Zenyatta in here, Deus Ex supporting Hawk's Bastion. And
look at Hawk just sticking right out there with the Bastion. I mean, he's got no shield in front of him there. Just
well, he did just wipe most of the team, so usually it's a pretty safe bet that you can move up.
That's
without
true.
Too much fear.
I think maybe I'm just too nervous.
Maybe. You can usually also, if you're listening, you should be able to hear most approaches
correct.
Around the corner. So.
Correct. Yeah, that's one thing you can't really get from the stream, I would say, is that you got to remember they are using the audio cues because your enemies are much louder. I do use that a lot.
We got Hawk back on the payload. Didn't get sucked into this alt here, but the alt just isn't working. But Ripper is able to connect something, but Link is going to come in here. Is he going to pop the res? Imagine he will.
Maybe no.
Out. He managed to pick him up, which is cool. Gets Blitzbolt up, and he's out again.
Sapphire's hurting here. Blitzbolt's out of mech. Yeah, I think Jade's gonna. Yeah, they're gonna clean house. All right.
They're just gonna keep this going.
They're gonna go right onto this checkpoint here.
So another really strong offensive push here.
Mm-hmm. But now they're coming up to one of the... Just past this checkpoint is a pretty good choke there because there's a bend in the path, so there's a lot of opportunity.
Ooh, this time got a little too aggressive, maybe. Freeze-Jaws trying to punish him, moving up, but not enough. Got to be careful with these teleporters. All right, he's good.
Oh.
Finds that Bastion, but gets taken down. His team kind of had his back.
I am really impressed with Hawk's Bastion play. That is... Wow.
Yeah.
Very good.
Got to use these sleeps right here to really counter him, especially that aggressive Bastion play like that.
Absolutely.
He's asking for a sleep. It's a very easy target.
Absolutely.
Let's see if Ninja's able to do it. Staying back a little bit here.
I'm looking to see who's in that Ninja's going to ult here. Probably Blitz, I imagine. Oh, my.
Nice. So even with that Zenyatta ult, doesn't really matter. Team Sapphire, this is their first big hold here that they've had.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a really challenging point for Team J to take. If you notice, their spawn is so far back, and Sapphire is going to refill very quickly, respawn very quickly. It's going to be hard potentially for them to deal with. But they got to be careful here. Trying way out of position over there. Gets picked up. And now Jade's got a good opportunity with this 5v6.
Fully charged Will there is Zarya.
Yeah, Will's ult really helped secure this, and now they're not going to have it. Narazuri takes out another one. We got Team Jade just pushing him in right now.
I still just can't get over the aggressive play from Hawk as Bastion. I don't know why.
Blitzball gets the ult.
Yep.
Don't have a lot of good targets for Anna. You know, it's okay. But Hawk is just running this down. Link trying to get that res off, but
not close
enough. Approach is a kind of a weird time, and
I think Jade's going to run this right through.
They've got a close spawn, so they're just trying to stay on it. They just need stall heroes right here.
Yep.
If they're able to get on this, it can really make it challenging there. D.Va can live. You know, they got the two lives. I think we got the res out of Link there, keeping his team up. Sapphire really trying to make a hold here, but they're kind of just crumbling apart.
Well, Freestraw is completely exposed there, but doing damage still. He's got to get up behind them.
Oh, one shot left on Yibo. Could have done something there. We got Blitzbolt now on the payload again. He's really making this challenging for them to work with, and Link's there as well. He's behind the point, just trying to stay alive.
Wow, look at that.
Really great play there.
Great job, Link. Wow.
We've got the ult up, pushes them back. They're just burning time right now, even if they don't get it, which it looks like this probably is going to be the end.
They're chipping away that timer, though.
For Team Sapphire.
That's great. Wow. Very well played.
Took a big difference there of a 4-minute rush and turned it into a 2-minute. I mean, I think I'm exaggerating, but still, down to 2 minutes, that's an okay time. You can work with that.
I think so.
Saw a lot of really impressive use of environment for blocking as well.
Yeah,
which I think I mentioned that week after week, but it's something that I always aspire to play just as well because we see our best players use the environment as their cover.
Mm-hmm. Well, you notice Link was kind of like hiding behind that payload there.
Yeah.
It was very cool to see.
That's something you don't see. You can see it from that third-person perspective, but when you're playing, I don't really see that because you're so concentrating on everyone's position and whether or not they're alive and what their ults are, but you don't see that use of cover like that. That was great.
Yeah. I mean, ideally, the other team doesn't know that you're there, which is important. But it bought him a little time, which is very cool. Do you know what this scene is from here?
Uncharted?
No. What? I think this was from the comic, of McCree's comic.
Oh, sorry. I thought you meant reference to another. No. I mean, I imagine it's from McCree.
You gotta read the comics, man.
I probably should.
Not a fan of the lore, I guess.
I don't know.
I mean, what happened here? Like, look at this, kid. Look at this. Do you ever look at the maps? Wonder?
Yeah, sometimes. I mean, I guess I just kind of take it as... I guess I don't question enough about why I'm fighting for this.
Yeah, all right. Fair enough.
And they look like there's more carts than would have fit between there.
Yeah. That's, I mean, I would say
those two
and maybe like
the third
one other.
Well, we'll say that it rolled back, so...
Maybe.
Fell off.
All right,
back to the... Back to
we got a double Bastion play. This is Team Bastion all day long.
Wow. So we got Blitzbolt and Hawk doing the Bastion roll this time.
Blitz not a good
Blitz, no, that's a bad spot, man. Ooh. All right, let's see what Hawk does.
So
D.Va's eating that up, so is Freestraw's.
Yeah, having the D.Va is really going to be effective.
The one thing I noticed with Hawk is he's a very, I mean, you should be, but he's a very mobile Bastion. I think in Potato League, you see Bastions that just park it, sit there till they die, and then repeat. Whereas if you're watching Hawk play, he's doing a lot of movement. So.
Ooh, no ammo.
Oh, Blitz switched over to Pharah now.
There we go. Yeah, so. He didn't have the heart of the hawk, so to speak, to make that work. Ooh, running right into him.
My.
Look at that charge again. Will, really.
Will, strong Zarya.
Oh, yeah. See, this is going to be hard to deal with.
It is because of his
support.
Yeah. But look, again, using the environment. Look, he knows that he can use that as cover.
Yep. He's hiding behind that little rock there.
Yeah.
Kept him alive for a while, at least. And it looks like Team Sapphire is going to be able to push through using that cover. Ninja picking him off.
But
And we've got that payload moving. We've probably won three on him. They do. I don't think Team Jade's going to be able to contest this, but they might try. No?
No, no.
Or you just try to see...
They're
going to
read
something.
Yeah, they're going to take... looks like they're going to group back up here. Hopefully, get away, Nirzari. Oh, okay.
He does. Now we got SJ Ripper here coming out with the soldiers near alt. Trying to pick up that Farrah. He almost does, but not quite. We're going to be able to hopefully see something happen here. We're going to have Yibo with the alt with the soldiers, so we definitely see a lot of damage come out of
it. Yeah, we can see a nice, nice combo wombo there.
Sniffing around, keeping an eye on stuff. Team Sapphire's kind of all spread out. Blitzbolt, though, doing a good job, getting up high.
Keeping the high ground.
That was a sloth fire strike.
That was pretty cool. That is going to make the highlight reel.
Picked up, but he falls asleep. What are they going to be able to do here? Need to get on that payload and prevent it.
Freestraw's shield is still very much alive.
Where's Team Jade right now? They're all kind of behind the point. It comes in from behind. Sloth picks him up. Takes him out. And
we got Link. Eliminated Link with the alt for the res as well.
Yep.
Wow.
I'm still waiting to see if this alt's going to come out of SJ Ripper. I guess he doesn't really need it at this point. Mm-hmm. As they kind of chase down the rest of Sapphire and... They start kind of pulling back a little bit here, knowing that they got.
Recollect themselves.
Team Jade having a strong hold here.
Very nice. Yeah.
And they've still got some pretty good alts ready for him. Sloth in a really, or Hawk in a really uncomfortable position there.
Very vulnerable, yeah. Oh, we got the surprise from behind there.
Yep. Nairzuri goes down for that, though, so I don't know if it was worth it. They're trying to make it connect, and SJ Ripper pops his ult, but it's in the midst of the Zarya or Zenyatta ult and Ninja's defense matrix, and he goes down. Blitzball doing some nice shots there. Might be able to take out Deus Ex, which he does. Sloth's the last one up. Sloth, big ult there. Might be able to.
Oh,
big miss there. Team J's not ready to give this up. Will, great shield there, keeping the Zen up, taking out Nairzuri. At 2 minutes, it looks like they're going to be able to push this in. Ooh, SJ Ripper on the point. Oh, all right. Taking out the healer, that's going to be really helpful, but the rest of the team kind of cascades down onto him. Without the healer, this could be pretty bad. And they've got the ult coming out of... Deus Ex. Kind of going toe-to-toe. Nairzuri ulting. They're getting pushed off the point, though, pretty aggressively. Hawk on this Tracer. Here we go. Might have an opportunity, but Will's also got his ult, and Blitzbulb says, I've got enough of this. You're all gone.
And on that particular cap point, the choke points, I mean, if you can get them with Farrah, if they poke out at all, you can answer that.
Yeah. Especially when you're already in that trickle mode. You don't have a lot of defenses. Deus Ex, gotta get behind the cover, which he does. He's just hot-shotting along, trying to make this Bastion work. And Bastion's pretty strong here as well.
Oh, especially in this corridor. Absolutely, yeah.
You're going to see him just kind of like laying.
Well, there's a lot of opportunity for cover here.
Freestraw's so low. Jade somehow managed to pick it up, but we got a big res coming out of late there.
Big res.
But...
huge grab by Nosari as well. Wow.
Sloth just keeping everybody up. Really smart move there. Looks like Will's not going to survive this either.
No. That was quite the answer from Team Jade, though.
Yes, really smart plays there. We got Ripper trying to chase down a couple of kills, keep them scattered.
He's doing the right thing. He's looking for those people that he can help take out.
Nice plays there.
The Dwindlers, as I like to call those players.
The Dwindlers?
The Dwindlers.
Blitzball lobbing some shots down the corridor there.
Oh!
Keeping them back, and you can kind of see him start to pick away at that shield.
Yeah, I mean, any sort of splash damage here, it really goes without saying that it's going to be your most effective.
This is
tight quarters. The map changes from wide open outside to tight, tight quarters.
That ult, though.
Nice Sloth.
Is he going to get free straws, though, is the question. He doesn't.
Free straws, evading that. Wow.
And our Bastion alt as well. Jade burned a lot of alts there without a lot of outcomes. We're going to see if SJ Ripper's able to make any. Oh, it doesn't matter. Hawk is connected. So we're holding the soldier.
Yeah, ult. Ripper's going to hold on to that. And we got Yibo with an alt, so we got another combo coming up.
Devastating combo.
And we got a minute left on the clock.
Yep. SJ Ripper might opt for a high position here to get the most out of his visor or continue to assist his team on the ground. I mean, usually soldiers want to take that high position just because you get really good trajectory and you can avoid a lot of other ults, but he's just going in deep.
And I don't,
Diva,
though. Oh, yeah. I mean, I don't care what anybody says. You're always looking at the horizontal plane more than the vertical, so if he's up above, that's another big factor as well.
Team J just totally got wiped on that, by the way. Another big ult out of Blitzball. It's potentially going to be carrying them to the win.
They are going to walk this
in. Oh, and Will.
Get behind that. Jeez.
Will ults them, and they're going to take it right there. So we're going to another
OT there.
We're fine. 8:30 is when the next one they're supposed to start, so even if we start a little later,
we'll
I think
good.
We just let it ride.
We started. What's going on with the countdown? Oh, we're good.
Yeah. All right. So, looking at our team strats here, you know, Sapphire's in a tight position here. They've only got a minute to push this payload through. But, you know, the thing about the payload maps, when you've only got a minute, you can still push it a really far distance. On the flip side, though, Jade does have 2.5 minutes, which is pretty good. That's multiple pushes on the payload. You could wipe a couple times along the path and still recover. Sapphire, they've really only got one wipe in them. They get wiped once,
pretty much done. Yeah.
So we'll see what they're able to do.
Jade, so if you're betting here, I was going to say I would probably err on the side of Jade on this one.
Jade's had a pretty strong hold.
I mean, they had a really strong hold on that last round, and they were so strong offensively. It would be hard for me to see them not be able to push it further with you know, being able to take one team wipe. So
they made some late decisions here to change, and hopefully they're able to get in position, which it looks like they are, but they opted for Deus Ex to switch over to this Mercy. Looks like he's just going to be able to charge up that Bastion. So they're really putting a lot of stock in Hawk. You know, they think that this is the guy who's going to lead them into victory and use that as kind of their biggest advantage.
Mm-hmm.
So speaking of using cover, you know, look at this payload use. They're just hitting right behind it.
Wow.
Totally neglecting a lot of his...
Sapphire's just running this right down here.
But...
Let's see what Hawk does.
There we go.
Okay.
Chase him right off the point. They got 20 seconds left already. This is not very far. So Team Jade, everybody's still up, and they're picking off kills. I think this probably is going to be it for Team Sapphire. I think this might be as far as they're able to push it. Maybe, you know, you never know. Some teams make some great plays in the final seconds. But this will definitely be challenging to be one of those players.
And Hawk's just going to park it right there on top of the payload.
Yep. Ninja, though, trying to make it.
Yeah, Ninja is being evasive.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, wow.
But the ult comes down. His deflect is down as well. So he's really not going to be able to do too much. Really good play out of Team Jade there.
Yeah. There's still a pretty decent push, I would say. Fine.
It's going to take a miracle for Team Sapphire to hold this off for two wipes.
Yeah.
Well, multiple. They got 2.5 minutes.
No, I guess they could potentially do 3, maybe 4 wipes before the timer runs out.
Full wipes without any sort of
stabilization. So they don't have to contest it during that time or anything.
Good luck, Team Sapphire.
I don't know. We've seen some pretty amazing things in this league, so if they do, there's still a chance.
Oh, for sure, yeah. I mean, you definitely don't want to underestimate your opponent at any point in time, because
we've seen that come back and burn teams. I mean, we saw that last week even with Jade's matches.
You know, there's some really great little Sombra play coming out of Free Straws here. They might be... You know, I don't like to use the word throwing, but... I mean, maybe he's thinking he'll be able to run some flank routes, I guess.
This is
Bastion.
Maverick's favorite character.
It is my favorite.
He does get a lot of flack, though, when he enters. He's got to really explain to everyone that I'm a high enough player to do this. It's okay. Yeah.
Not easy to do. Not easy to convince. But this, I think this means that we will have seen the full roster now played.
In
nope,
the league?
Not Torbjorn. We haven't seen any Torb yet, I don't think. Or maybe we have.
Yeah, I'm not sure. In regulation league, I'm not sure if we have. Yeah.
So just for those Symmetra mains out there, you do not want to leave your transponder in the enemy territory where they're going to walk onto it and pick it off. So usually you want to drop it by one of the health kits there so you can jump into it. Sapphire doing a reverse hold. Oddly effective. Not going to lie.
Very
did not
strange.
Think that was going to work.
Yeah.
But it did work. And
wow.
Now... we're looking at 2 minutes here. That was pretty
okay,
impressive.
Okay, so that was the... I would count that as one wipe. Okay.
They did a weird reverse hold where they held in the back, snuck behind them, which bought them a solid 45 seconds on the push. So,
yeah.
Very cool stuff.
Really cool
Blitz
play.
Blitzball building up his ult on the payload and holding them back.
Payload's
here.
Still going backwards.
But see, this is a really dangerous position.
Ooh.
But they're able to pick up Blitzball, then he's going to ult him. Man, I feel like I definitely spoke too soon. We're looking at a minute 20, and Sapphire might be able to hold this. Freestraw is just above.
Wow.
Taking pot shots, hacking that Rhine.
Alt's going up here real fast for Freestraws.
Blitzball is just shredding this enemy team. They're not dealing with this at all.
Oh, my. Sapphire wants this bad.
Yeah. I'll be honest, I'm pretty shocked here. We're looking at a minute left. Now they're almost at even playing
they're
field.
Even, yeah, I was like, this is even playing field. This
yep.
is it. I mean, they basically, Sapphire said, you guys
ooh,
are going to start
big EMP
with the
right
same
here. Mess. She's going to pop it.
And, capped, what was that, four players in
yep.
that. And that's going to just, I mean, Sloth is done at that point. But great
pop
in
the ult, and they pick up Freestraws right here. Ooh, Trine's going to need to be ready for this ult when needed.
Yeah. Try and get ready. Got to pull it at the right time before your team gets... There we go.
Ooh, Rhine comes
ooh.
In. Dives kind of the
Sloth's
wrong target.
Sloth's right behind right now.
Sapphire's going to make this hold. Ooh, Ripper, though.
Oh.
But the res from Ignite from
wow.
Deus Ex.
Deus Ex did the res.
It. Wow. I feel like such a jerk off now.
Yeah, wow. The reverse hold maneuver.
Wow. I can't believe that. So the reverse hold manages to play off with a Sombra. Really amazing stuff there. I actually can't believe that that actually worked.
That was...
Wow.
Like amazed at that.
Reverse hold? That was awesome.
So, it takes a lot of guts to make a maneuver like that because you might be sitting there looking like a big idiot when they just walk the payload through, but they didn't. Now I get to see an ult coming out of here.
Yeah. Oh, right in that corridor.
Nice.
That's Blitzbolt. Nice.
That's Blitzbolt again, actually, for those res. Really nice play there. Oof. Team Jade's cannot feel good about that.